Hello, dear all. Good morning. A very, very good morning to you all. Now, after the vacation, we all proceed forward to start with a new lesson, of course. And for you, the name of the lesson would be, I think, so this one, something a very simple lesson that needs a very practical way to understand, practical way to crush the knowledges of this lesson. And this lesson, you all know, that deals with the magnetism. So it is coming from your textbook. That is the moving charges, and magnetism. Okay, moving charges and magnetism. So by the word of moving charges, you means charges can be moved in a wire. Means straightly you can say that the charges are moving in a wire, means the current is flowing, and due to current flowing in the wire, there exists a magnetic field around the wire. Okay, and that is the chapter name, is the actually chapter is on that basis, that is the magnetic effect of electric current, but in our chapter it is named as moving charges and magnetism. So the current carrying conductor, that is the moving charges, creates the magnetic field, and what all effects we are having here on this magnetic field, say the motion of charge particle in the magnetic field, etc., etc., all these things we'll be learning in this chapter. So for this particular chapter, the moving charges means the current flowing and the magnetism, we first try to understand a very basic one, that is the very basic vector operation. And this is the a special vector operation known as the vector product. A special vector operation, isko hum log kya bolte hain, hum log vector product of two vectors, a and b. So for example, I take this vector as A and this vector as B. Okay, is it visible to you? These two vectors are like this aligned, say A vector like this, B vector like this. These two vectors, you can say, they are lying on the same plane. See, this is the plane, and on the same plane, these two vectors A and B are lying on the same plane. Now we have to find the vector product of two vectors A and B. So what we do is that here we see that the vector product of two vectors, that is A vector cross B vector, is equal to the mod of A into mod of B into the sine of angle between these two vectors and this n cap. All right, so just you see it here, that you can say that the angle, you see the angle is here, these are the two vectors, this is the angle. Okay, this is the angle. Now see, you can represent these vectors also here. Say this is your one vector, that is your A vector, and say this is your another vector, say this is your B vector. Then this angle is your theta. Angle between these two vectors is theta. Then what is A cross B? A cross B is also a vector. A cross B is also a vector. See, A cross B here is a vector, right? So A cross B is also a vector. Now the direction of A cross B, where n cap, you can say n cap, it gives the direction. It gives the direction of A cross B vector, and n cap vector is perpendicular to A, and n cap vector is perpendicular to B. So what is this n cap? N cap gives the direction of A cross B and normal to A vector and B vector. Okay, now if you try to make it understand here, say what is your n cap vector? You take a screw. You take a screw and put the big part of the screw here and rotate the screw from A to B. Rotate the screw from A to B. This screw will proceed in this direction. So this is the n cap vector. So you can draw this n cap vector like this, This is the n cap vector. So n cap vector direction, and also you can say this n cap vector is a unit vector. Unit vector. It is only required to give the direction, that is n cross b ka direction dikhane ke liye hum kya karte hain, n cap vector se hum denote karte hain. Now you see in these two vectors, this particularly see this vector. This n cap vector, this unit vector n cap vector is perpendicular to A, and it is perpendicular to B also, right? So in this way we are understanding this vector operation. Now after this vector operation, let's go forward, that in the studying of this moving charges and magnetism, we have to see some important concepts. Okay, we have to see some important concepts, like, you know, magnetic force on a charge moving with velocity v. Magnetic force on a charge Q moving with velocity v in uniform B field. Okay, so this expression is given by the magnetic force FM is equal to Q into V vector cross B vector. Alright. So this FM is a vector. What is FM? It is the magnetic force. The magnetic force, this is the FM. This FM is equal to Q into V cross B. Where you see this FM is actually, it is a cross product of V and V vector. So here you can say this FM is perpendicular to V vector, and your FM is perpendicular to B vector. Okay? FM is perpendicular to B vector, and FM is perpendicular to the V vector. Now, what all things we try to make to understand is that, say for example, we try to make it understand that, for example, you are having, say, a magnetic field like this. Now we are having the magnetic field like this. Okay, now in this magnetic field, if you are having like this, and a charge particle, say a charge particle Q is entering inside the magnetic field with the velocity V. The magnetic field is B, the charge particle Q is entering inside the magnetic field. Now as this charge particle will enter inside the magnetic field, so magnetic field B means it is pointing inside, and velocity is what? There. So if you take the vector product, say this is the B, ye B hai aur ye V hai, to dekho inka vector product kahan se kahan lena hai. What is the magnetic force? Magnetic force ka value kitna hota hai? Magnetic force is equal to Q into kya hota hai? V cross B. तो तुम्हें स्क्रू लेना है और V से B की ओर घुमाना है. ये V है और B है, दोनों परपेंडिकुलर है. तो हम स्क्रू लेकर के V से B की ओर घुमा रहे हैं. देखो V से B की ओर घुमा रहे हैं. ये देखो अभी कहाँ जा रहा है ये स्क्रू? ऊपर में जा रहा है. ठीक है. सो दिस इज एक्चुअली द डायरेक्शन ऑफ FM. दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ योर FM. सो हियर वी विल बी गेटिंग द डायरेक्शन ऑफ FM एज लाइक दिस. This is the direction of your FM we are getting. Okay, now see that B and V, they are perpendicular to each other, hai na? So as you can say that V and B are perpendicular to each other, hai na? So Fm will be K into Vb sine of what? 90 degree. Now it comes to be your Q into V into B. This is the value of your Fm we are finding it. Okay. Now this, after this Fm, thus we got this particular value. Okay. There is no doubt, I think so. It is clear to you. Now next point is that we deal with the force on a current carrying conductor. Force on a current carrying conductor of some definite length. Okay. So this is the topic named the force on a current carrying conductor of length L. So this is our concept, that force on the current carrying conductor of length. So what you do is that you take this conductor, current carrying conductor, like this. Okay, this is the conductor. Okay, Hannah, now placed in uniform what? B. Okay, now this is placed in the uniform magnetic field. This is placed in the uniform magnetic field like this. Okay. Now these are having the charges now. These are having the free charges. Say the conductor is having free charges. If it is connected to the battery, then what happens? This charges, they start drifting with the drift velocity V. With drift velocity, how much? Vd. Okay. Thus what happens? There you can say that there is a current flowing in the conductor. There is a current flowing in the conductor. And the length of the conductor is L. And here we are having, the length of the conductor is L. And here we are having, A is the area of cross section. Area of cross section. Now let's assume that inside the conductor, there are N charge carriers per meter cube. Okay, charge carrier per meter cube. Okay, now if you have the single charge, say Q, if single charge, then what is the force on the magnetic force on single charge? It is Q, say Q, or velocity kaha hai, iski Vd yahan par hai, to Vd cross kya ho gaya? B. Theek hai, Q into Vd cross B. We have seen from the initial equation that the magnetic force on a moving charge is equal to charge into velocity into this. Now then what is the total force on these charges? The how many charges are contained in this conductor? So the total force, this is the total force Fm can be said as number of charges into this small force. That is particular thing. So you can say this Fm is equal to this number of charges will be how much? See, number of charge carriers per meter cube, it is n. Okay, n ke saath mein kya karna hai, meter cube hai, to area aur length ke saath kya karna hai, isko multiply karna hai, area length ke saath multiply karna hai. Aur fir har ek ki charge agar q hoga to in sab ki charge kitni ho jayegi? Q ho jayegi. Uske baad fir hame hamare paas kya yahan par hai? Vd hai. Theek hai, Vd है, n into है, यहाँ पर Vd है, और यहाँ पर क्या करना है, इसको cross भी करना है, ठीक है? तो n into Q into A into Vd, देखो ये वाला expression, ये expression समझ में आया कि नहीं? Fm is equal to total force, that is number of charge carrier here into Fm. What is n? N is the total number of charge carrier in kya hai, this is the in the wire. So n, and n is equal to hum number of charge carrier per meter cube ke sath mein a into l multiply karenge, aur charge ke sath mein q karenge, vd aur b ho jayega. So by from the initial chapter, n q a into vd isko hum log kya bolte the, that is the current, okay, so current cross B as NQ A times VD is equal to current. From the drift velocity chapter, we have studied in the last chapter, we have studied of current electricity, that NQ A VD is equal to I. So this very important expression, we got it, that FM is equal to I into L or B. Now this, see here, current is a scalar quantity, L. So I into L, direction of flow of current, if you know, then I into L can be stated as vector, and B is also a vector here. So this is the magnetic force on a current carrying conductor. Okay, now say, for example, if you are having, say that if you are having this IL is perpendicular to B, then there is a magnetic force will be how much it is, I into L B, or kitna ho jayega, ye sin theta ho jayega. So the magnetic force will be how much, B into I into L, bill itna newton, theek hai. This is got it, you got it now. So this is the very easy way to understand this. The next part of the things I will make you understand just after a short video, okay? After some time we will make you understand the next part. Thank you.